Hi everyone, today I would like to talk about self-service charts in Kickstarter desktop. What does it mean self-service? Self-service is some kind of functionality, some kind of logic that we're applying to our dashboard, letting our end users to be able to modify chart dimensions, even measures, just by clicking. What does it mean? Let's go to see our raw data. Here we have date, age group, name, product, and amount. These are our columns and from our raw data. Example, if you would like to create date over age group, date over name, and date over product, some bar chart for using only two dimension and calculating amount. For this, for date, we have three options: age, name, amount, and some product. For age group, we have three options. If we would like to create charts and showing this data, somehow we have to have 9 different charts. Rather than having 9 charts, we can create only one chart, and we can just only click example age group we would like to see, and we can see amount, so it's easy, age and amount we have already. Then we can click on date. Here we are, age group and date is already applied, and summing amount, age and name, or age and product, and age group and product. Here we are. Let's do how we can achieve it in Kickstarter desktop. Let's start from the scratch. Let's create new application in Kickstarter desktop. Let's call it Six Service. Let's open it. We have inline data source. I will paste this in the description. You can just copy and paste from there. And just load it. Done. And let's see our data. Let's into table format to see our data. Let's fields. We have date. And we have name. Then age group, product, and amount. Here we are, we have all the needed fields. Then what we need right now, so as we can have, we have to have two dimension, additional two dimension, which dimension will let us filter, will be choosing column names. So it's our column names. So let's add new, make it column 1 with the name and load inline as in column name dimension 1. Control V, and here we are, age group, amount, and product 1 again, dimension 1 and comma here. It's easier, Control C and Control V. And let's make it column 2 and dimension 2. Let's load it. Close. Here we have data. And for, let's add one bar chart, which will we will change its dimension and have two filter pane. Here and add a dimension 1, Control C, Control V. Here we are. Let's add here dimension 1 and this is dimension 2. Here we are. You can change down editing, save amount and date, amount and amount, amount and product. So we can choose easily. So from the starter, we have to have some dimension. Let's add one dimension, two dimension here, our bar chart to form. Let's add date, first value, then add age group as a second, as a bars, and add one measure, with some amount. Here we are. This is our first chart. What we would like to achieve right now, as soon as we'll choose from dimension 1, this first dimension of this should change, date should change according to dimension 1 chosen, and second dimension 2 should be chosen as a bar, as we choose here, the dimension 2 bar should be changed. So how we can see here, as we can see here, as soon as we just choose the seed dimension amount, as we can see here, dimension 1 it's declaring here amount. It means from this field amount value has been chosen as name here, from dimension to name value has been chosen. So we can just get these values, what value from which a dimension has been chosen. So for this we come here. So this is our first dimension. Rather than having date here, we are telling if we have function in click send get field selections. What's our field name? Our field name is dimension 1. So it will return us the value that we have chosen from first dimension. Is equal to, so let's go in here and let's copy for easier and go over. So let's what we are doing here, control B, it's equal to date. And it is date. And let's add comma here. How many fields we have? Control D. We have only 4. We have 5, yeah. Let's copy it and let's give first name. Second is name. It's equal to name, should be name. Equal to age group, should be age group. Amount. Amount we will be choosing, it's possible we will choose. It's not necessary, but we can add here product, and we can add product, and here product. So if nothing will change, we would like to add here date. Date should be our. If nothing will choose chosen from first dimension, date will be primary. Here we are. It's okay, it says our. It's okay, then apply here. Then let's go to second age group. It's our primary. So let's add control D. Rather than dimension 1 here, this is the second field, so that's the dimension 2 it should be here, because we have the same control D and control V. And if nothing will be chosen, it should be age group. And we have 2 equal sign. Okay, it's okay. Let's choose age group. Oh, and as we can see here, it's been choosing age group. It's 18 to 23, 23 to 30, 30 to 40. Then if we choose date, it will be date. If it will be name, oh, it's our name values from the name field. Here we already achieved how it can be chosen. But what I don't like here, as you can see here, it's like it's showing us some kind of label as calculation. So let's get rid of it, make it more beautiful. And let's copy. Easier. And let's go to label, control V. And let's select this. It's the date. It should be date, name should be name, age group, and should be age group, amount, and amount here, product, and nothing will choose. We already mentioned that this should be control C. Let's apply here, and let's go to the second one, control V, and we have less than dimension 1, it should be dimension 2 here. Let's control C and copy and paste to. Here everywhere, change it. Here we are, it's name and it's amount, name and date, name, and then not name, age group, and date, age group. It looks so much beautiful. But can we add some kind of label, because we would like to know, rather than not looking at here, somehow we can share that put here that date column over age group. So we can achieve it so much easily. Let's go to our appearance, go to general, and we have title here. Here we are. So let's go to our label, because we already know that this calculation will give us first dimension that's chosen for our chart. So go to appearance. Let me add to link here. Okay, it will print us date or cal, and we can just select it and calculation over, and this, and it's first, it will give us the first dimension chosen. We can add second one with, of course, and sign. We can tell dimension 2, and let's copy and I paste here, and let's and sign dimension. And it's like it's done. Okay. Date calculation over age group dimension. Age group, it will be enough. Dimension is much. I think we don't need this. And here we are. Ski. Okay. Date calculation over age group. But if I will choose age group over amount, age group calculation over amount. Here looks much more better, and rather than having so many columns, we can give our end user so much beautiful solution like this. Thank you for joining us today. See you at the next videos.